Hi, I'm Richard Tomlinson. In this video, I want to show you how to know exactly when your maple syrup is done boiling. After tapping your maple trees and collecting the sap, it's common to boil the sap outdoors over a wood or gas-fired evaporator in order to eliminate most of the water content from the syrup. The finishing boil is best performed on a stove so that you have greater control over the heating temperature. Water boils at 212 degrees Fahrenheit at standard conditions, and at those same conditions, finished maple syrup boils at 219 degrees Fahrenheit. These temperatures may be slightly different based on the temperature and pressure where you live, but in general, 219 degrees Fahrenheit is a good rule of thumb. For this reason, it's a good idea to monitor the temperature of your syrup with a candy thermometer as the syrup approaches its final stages. The temperature of the syrup will gradually increase as the sugar becomes more concentrated. The hardest part about making maple syrup is knowing when to stop boiling. Sure, you can stop whenever you want, and it will probably be fine, but if you don't boil long enough, your syrup will be too watery. If you boil too long, it will crystallize. The Maple Syrup Institute and the USDA state that officially, maple syrup must have a sugar concentration between 66 and 68.9% by weight. So, when should you stop boiling? There are three ways that are commonly used to determine when maple syrup is done. The first is based on experience. Many old-timers have the experience necessary to know when the syrup is done just by looking at the boiling bubbles and watching the syrup slide off a spoon. The second method is using a hydrometer. This is a glass tube with a lead weight in the bottom of it. You draw off several ounces of syrup into a test cup. Then you gently set the hydrometer into the syrup. How deep the hydrometer sinks tells you the density of the syrup, and from that, you can back out the sugar content. The third, and in my opinion, the easiest method, is to use a refractometer. This device looks sort of like a small telescope. You place 3 to 5 drops of syrup on the viewing slide, close the cover, and then look into the viewport. The top portion of the scale is blue and the bottom is white. The line separating the two indicates the sugar content of your syrup. I'll put a link to the refractometer I use in the video description in case you're interested. As you're boiling your syrup, and the temperature is beginning to approach 219 degrees, you'll notice that you need to start decreasing the heat on your stove to keep it from boiling over. That's a great clue that you should begin sampling the syrup with your refractometer. Use a medicine dropper to place 3 to 5 drops on the slide. Close the cover and take a reading. You can watch the sugar content reading stabilize as the temperature of the syrup cools to room temperature. Several drops of syrup take about 15 seconds to cool. Here, a sample of syrup is taken and read using a refractometer. The resulting sugar content is 58%. The slide is wiped clean with a damp cloth. Several minutes later, another reading is taken. Now, the resulting sugar content is 62%. A little later, checking again, the sugar content is 64%. Keep checking the sugar content every several minutes until it reaches 66%. Here we can see the refractometer reading when the sugar content is at 66%. At this point, you can remove the syrup from the heat. Your syrup is done. You now have official maple syrup. I hope you found this video helpful. If so, please subscribe to view my other videos on making maple syrup, such as the one on how to properly filter syrup to reduce nitre and sugar sand. For more details on this and other topics related to maple syrup, check out the How to Make Maple Syrup podcast, wherever you get your podcasts from. I'll include a link to the podcast in the video description. Thanks for watching.